Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. If x plus y plus z equals 3, x squared plus y squared plus z squared equals 3, x to the power 3 plus y to the power 3 plus z to the power 3 equals 3. We want to solve this system to find values of x, y, and z. This is a challenging question. First, we define three new variables. A equals x minus 1. B equals y minus 1, c equals z minus 1. Why? Here's why. Sum of those three new variables, a plus b plus c equals x minus 1 plus y minus 1 plus z minus 1. Simplify the right-hand side, we have x plus y plus z minus 3. Here we have negative 1, negative 1, negative 1, negative 3. X plus y plus z is given, which is 3. 3 minus 3 equals 0. We got first result. A plus b plus c equals 0. This is the purpose. We want to get rid of the 3 from the right-hand side. Let's check a squared plus b squared plus c squared. Simplify the right-hand side. We have x squared minus 2x plus 1 plus y squared minus 2y plus 1 plus z squared minus 2z plus 1. Regrouping. We have x squared plus y squared plus z squared minus 2 times x plus y plus z. Plus 3. We have 1 here, 1 here, and 1 here. X squared plus y squared plus z squared equals 3. X plus y plus z also equals 3. This equals 3 minus 2 times 3 plus 3 equals 0. We have the second result. A squared plus b squared plus c squared equals 0. Now we want to check a to the power 3 plus b to the power 3 plus c to the power 3 equals x minus 1 to the power 3 plus y minus 1 to the power 3 plus z minus 1 to the power 3. Simplify the right-hand side. The right-hand side equals x to the power 3 minus 3x squared plus 3x minus 1. Similarly, we have y to the power 3 minus 3y squared plus 3y minus 1 plus z to the power 3 minus 3z squared plus 3z minus 1. We use the quadratic equation to have those three results. Regrouping equals x to the power 3 plus y to the power 3 plus z to the power 3 minus 3 times x squared plus y squared plus z squared plus 3 times x plus y plus z. Negative 1, negative 1, negative 1, we have negative 3 here. From those three given conditions, this part equals 3, this part also equals 3, and this part equals 3. This equals 3 minus 3 times 3 plus 3 times 3 minus 3 equals 0. We have the third result. In summary, we have three results here. From the first result, we take the third power on both sides. This implies 0 equals a plus b plus c to the power 3. We can use the binomial formula twice or in different way. You can get the following result. Grouping those items. Now you can see first part, a to the power 3 plus b to the power 3 plus c to the power 3 equals 0. From the first equation, b plus c equals a. B plus c equals a. A plus c equals b. A plus b equals c. Then we have 0 plus 3a squared minus a times minus a. 3b squared times negative b plus 3c squared times negative c plus 6abc. Simplify. We have 0 equals negative 3 times a to the power 3 plus b to the power 3 plus c to the power 3. This part from our third result is 0. This implies 0 equals negative 3 times 0 plus 6 times a times b times c equals 0 plus 6abc. This implies 6 times a times b times c equals 0. Six ABC equals 0 implies at least one of A, B, C equals 0. Say A equals 0. A plus B plus C equals 0. This implies B plus C equals 0. Therefore, C equals negative B. From the second equation, a equals 0 means b squared plus c squared equals 0. Here, in this equation, we replace c by negative b. Then we have b squared plus negative b, then square equals 0. B squared plus b squared equals 0. This implies b equals 0. Now we have a equals b equals 0 because a plus b plus c equals 0. This implies c equals 0. We have three results. A equals b equals c equals 0. By definition, a equals x minus 1, b equals y minus 1. C equals Z minus 1. A equals 0. X equals 1. B equals 0. Y equals 1. C equals 0. Z equals 1. This implies X equals Y equals Z equals 1. Therefore, 1, 1, 1 is the only solution. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.